All right. Hi, everyone.
Hello.
My name is Roby, and today I'm going to introduce you guys to a service app called Tudu. So in a nutshell, Tudu is a delivery service.
Get on the stage, please. Because we want to see the presentation.
All right, Tudu is a delivery service, and it just basically differs from the regular delivery services in the way it carries out what it does, basically. So Tudu delivers anything to anywhere, basically. The concept is that whenever you need something from somewhere, there's someone usually at that point, at that time, willing to get that stuff to you, basically. I define it as a productivity app because it's supposed to make you more productive. Let's imagine you're a student and you're in the dorm and you're working on your homework right now and it's due in the next 30 minutes and you also are hungry and you want some food from the cafe. The point of Tudu is that you can just put a request on the app and someone will help you get the food while you're doing your work. So it helps you get more done more effectively, basically. Aside from stuff like that, you can actually get more value from Tudu. If you look on the screen, there's two receipts, and they are both from Domino's for the same exact order. So it's a large three-topping pizza. They have very different prices. One goes for $8, and the other goes for around $18. The main difference between both is that the first pizza is a pickup delivery, and then the other one is actually going to get delivered to you. You can see the difference in price. Tudu helps you kind of find a medium between those two by having someone else who is at that point just bring it over to you, basically. How it works, Tudu basically works with software that is readily available today. But that's a bit misleading because I feel like Tudu works more with people. So the point is that it takes advantage of the interconnectedness between us to get it from everything. And how it does is that it incentivizes the process. There's an incentive to get this stuff done, there's financial incentive added to it. So you get paid by whoever asks you to do this current delivery. I think Tudu is geared towards the millennials to generation X-like generation, because I feel like that's the more tech-savvy generation. But there's also value for, like, for example, like the senior generation as well. Like St. Peter, for example, has a senior demographic that will probably derive value from having someone run errands for them, weed their gardens, and stuff like that. Also, Tudu focuses on students a lot. Students are not just going to be users of the app, they're going to be enablers to a very large extent because I feel like they are the ones who are going to be running most of these errands or helping out in one way or the other. And the focus with Tudu is on small. I feel like because we're in a small town and in a small college, there's already a community that is built that you can take advantage of straight away. You don't have to build these relationships between users and like actual enablers of the service. So we're gonna walk through Facebook logins because it's kind of personal. There's the fact that you can see the face of whoever it is you're dealing with attached to it. We're also gonna use student emails as another means to actually verify users as well. So how it basically works is we could actually have to do working through maps or hotspots. The advantage of working through hotspots is that in a small town like St. Peter, there's places where we all like frequent. So pretty much everyone gets groceries at Family Fresh or the Co-op. Pretty much everyone gets coffee from Caribou or the Hard Rock Cafe, or what's it called? River Rock Cafe, sorry. And just putting up those places on the app, let's just pick a location and be like, I want something from this place. And because it's a small town, it's easy to find someone to actually run the service between those spots. So the competition is, the market is actually pretty sparse, especially in small towns. There's a Favor who do delivery of food from restaurants to people through the apps. There's Magic, there's TaskRabbit. They are all kind of different in that they are skilled towards very, very large communities. And some of them actually like specialize in like heavy items as opposed to like pretty much anything, basically. I intend to market this service through students for the most part. I think students are gonna be the initial users of the app. I think the best way to do this is to incentivize registration with like a $10 sign-up bonus. So it allows them to use the app and like get familiar with the app right away. And then, like I said, financially incentivize it. So there's more than 200 post-secondary institutions in Minnesota, and more than half of them are small and private, so there's actually quite a market for it. Because these colleges are small, it's easy to, like I said, work with those hotspots and just pick parts in the towns where people actually frequent and just run services between them. Right now, I have the whole business actually planned out. There's the wireframing done, so you can actually go see a conceptual like walkthrough of what the app does. There's the UI design built as well already. I'm looking at around $4,000 to actually build this app and have it up and running. And I'm thinking of around $10,000 in marketing, basically. So the strength of this app is that it's highly customizable. You can use it to get a book from the library. You can use it to run errands, get someone to do your chores. It's also very, very scalable. It doesn't have to be limited to small colleges. You could also roll it out in mid-sized to huge colleges, or even like out in the general population. But for now, I'm focusing on like a small town and small colleges like St. Peter. Tudu basically focuses on value. The point is to provide value for its users. If you look at the top, the actual price or the minimum price of using Tudu to order a large size pizza, for example, is around $10. And that's compared to like the Domino's price of $18, it's like an $8 difference right away, which I'm sure students actually might actually find useful. And that's pretty much it. Thank you very much. On the freelance website called Upwork. So basically, the bulk of the cost will be in figuring out all the hotspots, because I intend to roll it out not just in Gustavus, I intend to roll it out in Mankato and the University of Minnesota as well, so it gives me an idea of what the market is like for small, medium, and large-sized universities, just as like a kind of beta testing to see what exactly is applicable. So it's going to have to pull up all the hotspots in St. Peter, for example, places people actually frequent, and then Mankato, and then the cities as well. So that's going to be the bulk of the costing, and that's actually the price I was given by the freelancers, basically.
How are you going to determine the hotspots?
Well, a town like St. Peter, I think, is actually pretty easy. There's not a lot of spots that you can actually get like stuff between. Like, so there's the grocery stores, there's the bowling alley, for example, and stuff like that. And another way to do it is to actually put out a survey and ask students what they want on the website. So there can be a suggest a spot link. So you can be like, oh, you need services from here to here, and it's just going to be like a simple text upload by PHP to the server, and that's it. So it's easy to like actually scale through the process, basically.
Okay, thank you.
Is this primarily a pull type app, or is it a push as well? So if I'm in Pizza Hut or Domino's or wherever, and I say, can I put the word out, hey, anybody who wants this, wants me to bring a pizza, I'm available, and I'll do up to five?
That's not exactly how it works.
So it's more like a task rep. You're really pulling the request. Exactly. And I guess the second is, besides the pizza kind of arbitrage, mm-hmm. price arbitrage opportunity, are there any others? Because my concern would be, do students have a lot of discretionary money that they'd be willing to pay TaskRabbit type?
Like I said, it doesn't have to be restricted to just running like goods. It could also be used for services. Like, you could actually help a good number of the population who actually have the finances to actually get things done, basically, like the elderly population here in St. Peter as well.